in the after time, meaning in our time. Who are the sabiqun, brothers and sisters? From the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his companions and the ones after them, they are the sabiqun. They have beaten us in two things. They are the sabiqun, meaning they are before us, and they are the sabiqun, meaning they have beaten us to paradise. And there is a small amount from this life, Allah says. There's only a minority that are still striving and working and desiring paradise and have left this world. Only a small amount, Allah says. As-sabiqun, as-sabiqun. Allah is praising the ones who race each other. Sibaq means race. Race, Allah says, is praising the people who race each other for the goodness, not racing each other for worldly things. No. As-sabiqun, as-sabiqun, Allah says, and those who can beat other people, in what? In good deeds. To beat each other to paradise, to beat each other in high places in paradise. No, a normal Muslim does not want just the first place in paradise. A mu'min wants to beat everyone and go to the Firdaus al-A'la. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said. He said, تَمَنَّوْ وَاسْأَلُوا الْفِرْدَوْسَ الْأَعْلَى. When you ask Allah for Jannah, ask Him for the highest place, which is called Al-Firdaus. Because these are the qualities of the believers. The believers are sabiqun, musbiqun, yatasabiqun. They always race each other for goodness. There existed two people which the Prophet ﷺ told us about in the time of the Prophet. And they used to challenge each other in everything they did. They loved each other for the sake of Allah. And they tried to pray and beat each other in prayer. So they pray night prayers and they would fast more days. When this friend heard about his brother, that he would fast 2 days, his brother would fast 3 days. When he heard about him, those who was fasting, every Mondays and Thursdays, the other brother would fast day on, day off. When he donated from his wealth this much, the other brother would beat him and donate that much. One day they went out to jihad, which is fighting a battle against people who were attacking the Muslims, attacking the oppressed ones, driving people out of their homes. So they thought, this is a great chance to reach the highest places in paradise, because Allah loves those who defend the weak. So they set out and they began to fight in the battle until they lost each other. Then one of them was a captive. And those oppressors' enemies, they caught this captive. And they said to him, they began to torture him. And torture him. And every time they tortured him, he began to laugh. And the mushrikeen said, why are you laughing? We're torturing you. You're a captive. He said, I am laughing because alhamdulillah, I am going to die a shaheed and beat my brother to Jannah. That's it. I've beaten him. And they said, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you Muslims? The same person like you we caught before, he said the same thing before he died. And then he started to cry. But he still died. And Allah says that they met each other in paradise. Al-mushtaquna ila al-jannah, those who desire paradise, work for it. They strive for it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described a mu'min in this life and he said, الدُّنْيَا سِجْنُ الْمُؤْمِنِ وَجَنَّةُ الْكَافِرِ. It is the prison of a mu'min, of a believer, and it is the paradise of a kafir, one who rejects Allah. Yes, it is a paradise, because they believe that this is the only life they're going to live. It's only one life, they say, it's a short life, so we might as well make the best of it. Get as much as we can from it. A mu'min doesn't think that way. He sees that everything in this world always calls him and her to doing haram things. It makes it difficult for us to worship Allah correctly and sincerely. It makes it difficult, especially in our time today, where the Prophet ﷺ said, there will come a time when Al-Qabidu ala deenihi kal-Qabidu ala jamratin min nar. The one who is holding onto his religion is like one who is holding onto a coal of fire. It's intense. It's difficult, brothers and sisters. But it is not difficult upon the one who anticipates a great reward in the hereafter. La wallah, abadan. Imagine you are a prisoner, or imagine you are an outcast, a stowaway, and you're stuck on an island. Or you are in a strange land. You have no family, you have no food, you have no water. And you just anticipate to getting back to your family, back to your home. Imagine what kind of a feeling that type of a person would be feeling when he is in a strange land, imprisoned, encaged. He will do anything and struggle in any way just to get back to his family, get back to his home, get back to security, wouldn't he? Sometimes even if it meant his life. If he is drowning and he is stuck in the water, he will struggle and strive in every way. Even if it meant that he has to use the last piece of energy and breath that he has in order to reach land. الدنيا سجن المؤمن. The world is like a prison for a mu'min. A mu'min, one who desires Allah, one who desires paradise. That's a mu'min. Are you one of them, brothers and sisters? If you desire paradise, then you work for it. And some people think that if you worship Allah, you should not work desiring paradise. You should only work because you desire Allah only. But this is wrong, and this is not the aqidah of a Muslim. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَعْبُدُونَهُ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. They worship Allah in hope and in fear. طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا وَطَمْعًا. And also greedy for Jannah. Because in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if their companion was in need, you would find that one of them, subhanallah, the one typical companion, would always put his brother in his place. Allah says in the Quran, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً. And they would deny themselves things when they themselves needed it in order to provide it for their brothers in Islam. Yes, if they were attacked by some people, they would go out and they would beat each other to the battlefield to defend the women and the children. Not only that, the companions would race each other. And you would find in those days, read the seerah, a companion would grab his brother from behind in his shirt and he would pull him to the back, throwing him behind him. Why? Because he says to his brother, Wallahi, you will not die before me. I will defend you instead of you defending me. I will not hear you defend me. I am not better than you. This is how they were. They loved each other to that extent because they loved paradise and they wanted to meet in paradise. There was a woman called Nashitat Fir'aun. She was a woman who was the hairdresser of Fir'aun's daughter, Pharaoh, who said, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِ. I did not know any God but me. And Nashitat Fir'aun, this hairdresser, she had embraced Islam in secret. And when she was combing the hair of the daughter of Pharaoh, the king, the one who said he is a god, the comb fell to the ground. And then she automatically, subconsciously picked up the comb and said, Bismillah, in the name of Allah. And this Mashtat Fir'aun, this hairdresser, had 5 children, and one of them was still breastfeeding. And then the daughter of Fir'aun said, Allah, Abi, are you saying Allah, my father? And she said, no, Allah, the father of Allah, the God of your father and yourself and me. And she became angry. She went to her father and said to him, Father, this woman worships another God beside you. He said, what? She know another God beside me? Who is there? Call her to me. And they called her to him. And then she came and stood, a woman, brothers and sisters, in front of this great Pharaoh. And he said to her, who is your God? And she said, Allah is my Lord. He said, who is Allah? He said, Allah Rabbi wa Rabbuk. Allah is my God and yours. Yes, when she was cornered and put in the place, when she had to answer, she answered. She answered. This is how the state of the mu'mins in the past and present are. When they said, Rabbi Allah, Allah is my Lord, they were tortured. But we don't care. Because we know what we are heading towards. We know who our Lord is, and we say what we believe. We are not liars. She said, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbuk. And then he said, what? Bring the chains. They brought the chains. They began to punish her and whip her. Who is your Lord? And she would say, Allahu Rabbi wa Rabbuk. And so he ordered for them to bring a large container. And then he spilled hot boiling oil into this container. Large container. like a swimming pool. And then he said, bring me all her children. And they brought them one by one. He said, worship me, I am your God. She said, never. So he brought her first son and he threw him into the oil. In front of her eyes, his meat and his flesh fell off his body, and then his bone disintegrated. Then they brought her next son, and she was firm, Allahu Akbar, and they burnt him. She could not stop him. And then her third, and then her fourth, then finally her fifth, he was on her arm, and she was about to pull back. She was about to pull back in front of the eyes of all the people, when all of a sudden, and this is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when all of a sudden Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from above seven skies made her child or infant speak while she is in the cradle, and he said, اصبري يا أمتي اصبري يا أمي اصبري يا أمي إنك على الحق. Be patient, my mother, you are on the truth. إن الله قد وعدك بجنة. Allah, Allah has promised you with a great heaven. Keep going, mother. And then they threw her son into the boiling oil, and then she was next. She knew that she was going to die, and then she began to cry, and Pharaoh said, why are you crying? Stop. And she said, I'm crying because I want to ask you to do something for me. I don't know if you will do it. He said, ask me for whatever you like. He said, once you throw me into the oil, then I want you to gather whatever is remaining of our bodies, and I want you to bury us together in the same grave, because I want to be resurrected with my children, and I want to go to Jannah with my children. I don't want them to go out of my arms. And she knew what this life was and what the hereafter was. And so they threw her into the oil, and she ended up in Jannah. Just like that man, that prophet, who Allah does not mention his name in the Quran, in Surah Yasin, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ يَسْعَى. And a man came from the far end of the Medina, يَسْعَى, meaning running towards them. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. He said, oh my people, follow the messengers. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ اتَّبِعُوا مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Follow the ones who do not ask you for any wealth. They're not asking you for any wealth or any ajar, any exchange. And they are the ones who are rightly guided. What did they do to him? They brought him, as in the hadith, and then they put a hole into the ground, and they dug him into the ground, and then chopped his head off. In another hadith, they threw him down the well and they killed him. And then Allah resurrected him and put him straight into Jannah. And Allah says in the Quran, and then he replied by calling out, Ya layta qawmi ya'lamun bima ghafani rabbi waj'alani min al-mukramin. He called out and says, oh, woe if only my people had known how Allah has forgiven me and what kind of a blessing He has put me in. Jannah, na'im, everlasting, everlasting luxury, everlasting freedom, everlasting bliss. If only my people knew where I have ended up. Ya hasratan ala al-ibad, ma ya'tihim min rasulin illa kanu bihi yastahzi'un. Oh, great sorrow and sadness to the people, servants of Allah. There isn't a messenger that comes to them warning them and promising them except that they would mock him. And this is our state today. What about Imra'at Fir'aun, Pharaoh's wife? She also embraced Islam in secret. And when Pharaoh found out, he brought her, as in the Quran, وَامْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ, and the wife of Pharaoh. In the hadith it says, he brought her, and then he stripped her naked, and he hung her to the ceiling from her breasts, and he began to torture her. He tortured her, and she began to cry. And Allah says in the Quran, وَمَرْيَمَ بِنَتَ عِمْرَانَ. ومريم, he said, وَامْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. She said, oh my Lord, what, she was being tortured. Oh Allah, build for me a palace in Jannah and save me from Pharaoh and save me from the people who are oppressors. The hadith says, while she was being tortured, Allah showed her a palace inside of Jannah, and she began to laugh, and Pharaoh began to torture her even more, saying, what is making her laugh? Torture her more. Isn't she feeling this? And she died laughing. Little did he know that Allah was showing her a place, her palace in Jannah, which made her forget the pain. It was too overwhelming. And she died seeing her palace.